So first things first, I'm going to start this video off by saying that I went to Harbor Freight unsupervised, so it's not my fault. Okay, there you have it. It's a 1-ton gantry. Let's see how well this thing holds up. Luckily, I don't need anything too heavy. That's the top bar there. I got a welding cart. I've had a welder for a couple of years now, and just kind of kept it in a storage box. So I finally got the cart to prop that on. Just a service cart to throw shit on when I'm working in the driveway, or even the go-kart frame, make it easier to move it around. Powder coat and gun, wanted that for a while as well. And I got the 1-ton chain hoist. I was debating on going a little bit bigger on that, but I figure whatever, gantry's 1-ton, might as well just stick with the 1-ton, keep it cheap. Some more flux core wire to weld with, and metal grinding wheel, cut down some of the great welds that I have. All right, let's go ahead and finish unboxing this thing and put it together.
Hopefully the tool stands up better than the Harbor Freight packaging. Just like any proper guy would do, take the directions. Don't need those.
So as far as wheels, we got two that lock, two that don't. We got grease fittings on the bearings. That's good. A lot of people like to complain that Harbor Freight is cheap crap. I believe just don't use it outside its limits. It's obviously cheaper, so it's not gonna do too much heavy duty stuff. You get what you pay for. I don't really need anything too big, so good enough for me. I need it for more light duty stuff, so in the future if I ever need anything bigger, then there's plenty of stuff on a marketplace.
why women live longer. Thank you. maximum load 250. I'm almost 240. Again, I'm unsupervised, and this is why women live longer. And this goes back to what I was saying about not using tools beyond what they're rated for. I got one bolt in. Falls. four bolts. We're good. Needless to say, that's why I bought that thing, because I never have people around to help me.